你那么久啊？
Sorry, school day. 可能是设置的原因。
我们可以开始吗？
可以，我们现在可以开始了。
ॐ अज्ञानतिमरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमः ॐ विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नाम्ने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषन्यवादी पश्चाचले सतारिणे वञ्चकौपातरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभयेव च पतितनं भवानेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवास और भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 6. And we're on chapter number six, canto six. It's entitled "The Progeny of the Daughters of Daksha."
我们学习的是圣典博伽瓦坛第六篇的第六章，这一章是当沙女儿们的后裔。So,
we heard about how Prajapati Daksha had 10,000 sons and then 1,000 sons, and both groups of sons renounced the world and followed the path of Narada Muni.
我们之前听说过，Daksha有10,000个儿子，后来又有1,000个儿子，这两批儿子都跟随着Narada Muni走上了气绝的道路。So
after that, Daksha decided instead of producing sons, he would be better to produce daughters.
所以在这些事情之后，Daksha就决定开始繁衍出一些女儿们，代替繁衍这些男孩子。He
knew that at least if he had daughters, then the Narada Muni won't trouble them.
他知道，如果他去繁衍，他能够生出一些女儿们的话，Narada
Muni就不会去给他找麻烦。Narada Muni is a brahmachari, so he doesn't take much time to associate with the opposite sex.
Narada Muni 是一个真守身，所以他不会花太多的时间与异性交往.
All right, so there's we're hearing about the different daughters of Daksha. He had 60 daughters, and he arranged for their marriage.
Daksha 有60个女儿，然后Daksha也为他们安排了一些婚姻。
A number of them were married to, they were married to Kashyapa.
有一部分是嫁给了Kashyapa.
And from Kashyapa, they were able to produce all different species of life.
通过Kashyapa结婚之后，能够繁衍出宇宙各种各样的生物种类.
So we're hearing about the different wives, how they produce different kinds of offspring.
我们现在来听不同的妻子，她是如何产生不同的生物种类的。
Text 27 describes Sukadeva Goswami telling Maharaj Parikshit. He said, from the womb of Surabhi, Surabhi was one of the wives of Kashyapa, from the womb of Surabhi came the buffalo, cow, and other animals with cloven hooves. They took birth.
Shukadeva Goswami 跟 Parikshit Maharaj 说，从 Surabhi 的子宫， Surabhi 是 Kashyapa Muni 的其中一个妻子，从 Surabhi 的子宫繁衍出水牛、母牛和其他偶蹄类的动物。
And then from the womb of Tamra, Tamra another wife of Kashyapa, the eagles, vultures and other large birds of prey took birth.
从 Tamra 的子宫繁衍出鹰、雕，还有其他巨大的鸟。
And then from the womb of Muni, the angels took birth.
从 Muni 的子宫繁衍出天使们。
Then there were sons were born of Krodavasa, and they were the serpents known as Dandasuka.
出生自 Krodavasa 的儿子们是名叫 Dandasuka 的毒蛇。
And there were other things like serpents and mosquitoes also.
还有其他的蛇类以及蚊子。
Then all the various creepers and trees.They were born from the womb of Ila.
所有种类的爬藤、树木都产生自伊拉的子宫。
And the bad spirits, known as the Rakshasas, they were born from the womb of Surasa.
Rakshas 还有邪恶的精灵产生自 Surasa 的子宫。
And the Gandharvas were born from the womb of Arista.
Gandharva 产生自 Arishta, Arishta 的子宫。
And animals whose hooves are not split, such as the horse, were born from the womb of Kasta.
不是分趾蹄的动物，如马匹，产生自 Kasta 的子宫。
Then from the womb of Danu came 61 sons.
从达努的子宫繁衍出六十一个儿子。
And of these 61 sons, 18 were very important.
在这六十一个儿子中，他们有十七，其中的十七个非常重要。
Then the daughters of Swarbanu, named Suprabha, were married to Namuchi.
Svabhanu 的女儿 Supapa 嫁给了 Namuchi.
And the daughter of Vrishaparva named Sarmishta was given to the powerful king Yayati, the son of Nahusha.
Vrishaparva 的女儿 Sarmishta 被布施给了孔武有力的国王 Nahusha 的儿子 Yayati.
That's described in the Srimad Bhagavatam about Sharmista and Devayani, how they were connected with Maharaj Yayati.
在圣典波迦瓦坛也讲述了 Sharmista in 的这一段故事。
All right. So then, Vaishvanara was the son of Danu.And he had four beautiful daughters.
Danu 的儿子 Vaishvanar 有四个美丽的女儿。
So Hiranyaksha, he married the one daughter called Upadanavi.
Hiranyaksha 娶了其中一个女儿，她名字叫 Upadanavi.
And Kratu married the daughter called Hayashira.
Kratu 娶了 Hayashira 这个女儿。
Then at the request of Lord Brahma, Kashyapa married Puloma and Kalaka, the other two daughters of Vaishvanara.
应 Brahma 的请求 ,Prajapati Kashyapa 娶了 Vaishvanara 的另外两个女儿 p Punoma 和 Kalaka.
And then from the womb of these two wives of Kashyapa came 60,000 sons headed by Nivatakavacha.
从 Kashyapa 的这两个妻子的子宫生出了六万个儿子，其中以 Nivatakavacha 为首。
Nivatakavacha. Nivatakavacha, he was known, these 60,000 sons were known as the Pulomas and the Kalakias.
这六个儿子，他们以名叫 Pulomas 和 Kalakia.
And they were physically very strong and they were expert in fighting.
他们的身体都非常的健壮。精于战斗。
And their aim was they wanted to disturb all the sacrifices performed by the great sages.
他们的目标就是去扰乱那些伟大圣人们所举行的祭祀。
And when Arjuna went to the heavenly planets, he killed all these demons.
当阿尔朱那去到天堂星宿的时候，他杀掉了所有这些恶魔。
And so King Indra was very grateful to Arjuna because Arjuna did this.
所以天帝 Indra 对 Arjuna 非常感激，因为 Arjuna 为他做了这个事情。
And there was this one king called Vibrachiti, and in the womb of his wife Simaika, he had 101 sons.
维帕钦提通过自己的妻子辛黑卡得到了101个儿子。
And the eldest son was called Rahu, and the other 100, they were called Ketus.
这101个儿子的长子是名为叫，长子是 Rahu, 其他100个儿子是 Ketu.
So all of these sons, they got positions to be influential planets in the universe.
这101个儿子全都获得了有影响力的星球的职位。
So Sukadeva Goswami said, now I'm going to tell you about the descendants of Aditi, and I'll tell you in chronological order.
现在 Sukadeva Goswami 说，我将会为你讲述 Aditi 的后裔，而且是按照年代的顺序给你讲述。
So in this dynasty, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narayana, appeared.
通过这个王朝，智者人格首身 Narayana 降临在这个王朝。
And this is where actually Lord Vamanadeva came.Is known as Urukram.
这个时候，主 Vamanadeva 来了，然后他的名字当时是叫 Urukram.
Samgyana, the wife of Vivashvan, the sun god, gave birth to the Manu named Shraddhadev.
太阳神维瓦斯万的妻子 Samgya 生的名叫 Vishvadeva 的。
Shraddhadeva.
Shraddhadeva the Manu.
And the same wife, the same fortunate woman, she also gave birth to twins. One, the twins were Yamaraj and the river Yamuna.
另外一位妻子生下了一对双胞胎，其中一个是Yamaraj， 另外一个是 Yamuna， 他们是一对双胞胎。都是为太阳神维瓦斯曼的儿子的孩子。
龙凤胎，
龙凤胎，对。
Then Yami, while wandering on the earth in the form of a horse, a mare, gave birth to the Ashwini Kumaras.
接着 ，Yami 以一头母马的形象在地球，形象漫游在地球上时，生下了 Ashwini Kumar。
And Chaya was another wife of the sun god, and she had two sons named Sanaischara and Savarni Manu.
太阳神的另一个妻子查亚生了两个儿子，沙奈查尔和沙巴尔尼马努。
And she also had one daughter, Chaya also had one daughter, Tapati, who married Samvarana.
Chaya 还有另外一个女儿，她的名字是 Tapati, 她嫁给了 Samvarana.
Then from the womb of Matrika, who was the wife of Aryama, there were...They give birth, they had many learned scholars born from their womb.
从阿尔亚玛的妻子马崔卡的子宫生出了很多博学之士。
And among them, Lord Brahma created the human species.
主 Brahma 在他们之中创造了被赋予自省人自省能力的人类。
And the special qualification of the human species.Was that they had an aptitude for self-examination.
这一种人，他们有一种特别的品质，就是他们能够自省、自我检查。
Then, Pusha had no sons.
Pusha 是没有儿子的。
And when Lord Shiva was angry at Daksha, Pusha had laughed at Lord Shiva.
当主希瓦对达克沙愤怒的时候，普沙嘲笑了主希瓦。
And when he was laughing, he showed his teeth to Lord Shiva.
当他在嘲笑的时候，他把他的牙齿龇牙咧嘴。
So Lord Shiva knocked out all his teeth. He lost all of his teeth. And when he lost all of his teeth, he could not chew anything. So he had to eat only ground flour.
所以主希瓦去掉了他所有的牙齿。当这个普沙失去了自己所有的牙齿的时候，他不得不靠吃生面粉度日。
Then Ratana was the daughter of the Daityas.
Daitya 的女儿 Ratana,
and she was the wife of Prajapati Twasta.
她是 Prajapati Twasta 的妻子。
And Twasta produced two sons in her womb, very powerful sons. One was Sannivesha and the other was Vishwarup.
Twasta 通过他的妻子得到了两个非常有力量的儿子，一个是 Sannivesha, 另外一个是 Vishwarupa.
So Vishwarupa was the son, he was the son of the daughter.Of the enemies of the demons.
Vishwarupa 是恶魔的女儿的儿子。
The enemy of the demons means the demigods.
半神人的敌人意味着，恶魔的敌人意味着是半神人。
So the demigods they accepted Vishwarupa as their priest.
半神人接受他为祭师。
Because the demigods' guru, their spiritual teacher, Brihaspati, had abandoned them. He'd gone away and left them, and they had no guru. So Lord Brahma told them they should take Vishwarupa for their guru.
因为半神们的灵性导师 Brihaspati 当时离开了那个祭师现场，所以主 Brahma 训令他们说你要找这个 Vishwarupa 为自己的祭师。
So when Maharaj Parikshit heard this, he was surprised. He thought, whoa, why did the spiritual master of the demigods, Brihaspati, leave the demigods?
当 Maharaj Parikshit 听到这么一个事情之后，他就询问到为什么半神们的灵性导师Brihaspati 要离开半神们呢？
No, the demigods were his own disciples.
这些半神们都是他的门徒呀。
So Maharaj Parikshit asked Sukadeva Goswami, what offense did the demigods do that caused their spiritual master to leave them?
Maharaj Parikshit 问 到底这些半神做了什么样的冒犯，导致他们的灵性导师离开了他们？
So this, we're beginning the seventh chapter now, and we're going to hear how Brihaspati was offended by the demigods and how he left them.
我们现在聆听的是圣典博加瓦坛第七章了，然后我们将会知道到底半神们是如何冒犯的 Brihaspati， 然后离开了。
And when the demigods were left without a spiritual master, then they were defeated by the demons.
当 Brihaspati 离开了这些半神人之后，这些半神人就被恶魔给打败了。
So Lord Brahma advised them to take Vishwarupa to be their priest.
主 Brahma 就训谕他们，你们应该接受 Vishwarupa 为祭师。
But there was a problem.
但是这里也有一个问题。
Because Vishwarupa had some affection for the demons.
因为Vishwarupa 和 demon 和这些恶魔有一些关系。
Vishwarupa, he was the, he was the son. His mother was born from the demons.
Vishwarupa 的母亲，她是生自一个，她是恶魔所生。
Although his father was from the demigods, his father was Twista, and Twista was from the demigods. Twista was very powerful.
虽然他的父亲是来自于半神，名叫 Twista， 他 Twista 也是非常有力量的。
And Twista was one of the Prajapatis, so he is powerful in the universe.
Twista 也是一位祖先，他也是宇宙中非常有力量。
But his wife was born from the demons.
但是他的妻子是由恶魔所生。
So Vishwarupa has some affection for the demons and for the demigods.
因此 Vishwarupa 既和半神们有一些关系，也和恶魔有一些关系。
Right. So we'll hear what.Sukadeva Goswami said. Sukadeva Goswami describes that one time the king of heaven Indra was very proud because of his opulence.
Sukadeva Goswami 说，有一次天帝的国王 Indra 非常的因为自己的物质财富而感到骄傲。
So he went against the Vedic culture.
他没有遵守韦达礼仪。
He was sitting on his throne, and he was surrounded by different demigods who were all worshipping him.
他坐在自己的宝座上，身边围绕着这些半神，这些半神也在崇拜着他。
And there were so many saintly persons also around him.
而且还有很多伟大的圣人也围在他的身边。
And they were all offering.Their respects to Indra and worshipping him.
他们都向 Indra 供奉，表示出自己的尊敬并崇拜着 Indra.
And people like the Apsaras and the Gandharvas, they were dancing and singing and playing sweet musical instruments.
Apsara 和 Gandharva 在美丽优美的旋律的伴奏下，也在唱歌和跳舞。
And they had a white umbrella over Indra's head. It was like the full moon.
在 Indra 的头顶上方有一个白色的华盖，就像一轮满月一样。
And on his side, there were people fanning him with yak tails. They were fanning him.
在 Indra 的身旁还有人为他用这个。牛尾的浮尘给他扇扇子。
And they had all different paraphernalia which are meant for offering to a great king. They were offering to Indra.
他们都有各种各样的，也带着各种各样的饰品，都服务着 Indra。
So Indra was sitting on his throne along with his wife Sachidevi, and Sachidevi had half the throne and Indra had half. They were both sitting together on the throne.
Indra 和他的妻子 Sachidevi 都坐在宝座上，他们一人坐一半。
So at that time, Indra's guru, the guru of the demigods, Brihaspati, came there.
在那个时候 ，Indra 的老师 ，Indra 的灵性导师，以及所有半神们的灵性导师 Brihaspati 来了。
So although Indra saw the spiritual master, he did not get up from his own seat. He did not offer any respect to his spiritual teacher.
即便 Indra 当时看到了他自己的灵性导师，他并没有离开自己的座位，也没有向他自己的灵性导师表示出任何的尊敬之意。
He didn't give him any kind of welcome. He did nothing to show him any respect.
他也没有去迎接他的灵性导师，总之他就没有对他灵性导师表示出任何的敬意。
So Brihaspati is a powerful.Sage, and he knew what would happen in the future. He could see the future.
Brihaspati 是一位非常有力量的人，他能知晓未来的一切。
So he saw what Indra was doing. He saw how Indra didn't give him any respect.
他看到了 Indra 在做什么，他也看到了 Indra 没有尊敬他。
He saw that Indra was puffed up of all his material opulence.
他能看到 Indra 完全被他的物质富裕而傲慢不已。
So Brihaspati could have cursed Indra, but he didn't do that.
Brihaspati 其实是有能力诅咒 Indra 的，但是他没有这么做。
Instead, he just went away. He went back to his home and he left him.
相反，他就离开了那个地方，回家了。
So Indra is the king of heaven.And he could understand they'd done something wrong.
Indra 是天地之王，他能够明白自己可能做了一些错事。
So he realized he'd committed an offense against his spiritual master.
他意识到自己冒犯了自己的迷信导师。
So he condemned himself for that.
于是他开始自责起来。
He admitted his guilt in front of all the members of the assembly. He told them, I've done a great sin. I've been very disrespectful to my guru.
他立即在所有聚会成员的面前表示出忏悔和愧疚之情。他觉得自己没有尊敬自己的灵性导师。
And Indra told all the people there, all the demigods, all the other demigods, he told them, I've committed a great offense.Because of, I'm not very intelligent, I'm very stupid, and I'm very proud.
Indra 在所有的半神面前表示出他的忏悔，他觉得自己缺乏智性，冒犯了自己的灵性导师，因为自己的富裕而感到骄傲。
Yeah, I'm very proud of all my material opulence.
我为我所有的这些物质富裕而感到骄傲。
I didn't show any respect to him when he came here in our assembly, so it's like I've insulted him.
当他来到我们这个聚会场所的时候，我完全没有对他表示出任何的尊敬，我侮辱了他。
So Indra said, "I'm supposed to be the king of the demigods, and I'm supposed to be in the mode of goodness."
我既然作为半神人的国王。那我就应该处在善良心态之中。
But I was proud. I was proud of a little opulence.
但是我却因为一点点物质富裕而感到骄傲。
And I have a lot of false ego.
而且我还有很多的假我。
So.I made this mistake. This is because of all. I've got too much wealth and too much opulence.
我做这么多的，我犯下的这个错误，全是因为我自己有太多的富裕。
So this is the problem when you get too much opulence. There's always a danger of falling down.
这就是富裕的问题，它总是能够造成一个人堕落。
Lord Chaitanya in his Shikshastikam, he teaches us, he warns us to be careful about too much wealth.
主 Chaitanya 在他的八训规也警告我们要非常小心这种物质富裕。
Lord Chaitanya says, Nadanam na janam na sundarim kavitam vajagadisha kamayi. He said, I have no desire to accumulate wealth.And I don't want to enjoy beautiful women, and I don't want followers.
主 Chaitanya 在八训规说，我既不想要物质财富，也不想要漂亮的女人，更不想要任何的追随者。
And he says, Mama Janmani Janmanishwari Bhavatad Bhakti Rahita Ketvai. I do not even want liberation.
主 Chaitanya 说，我甚至都不想要解脱。
All I want, birth after birth, is to be a good servant of your lotus feet.
我所有的愿望就是想一世复一世的成为您莲花足下的仆人。
So it happens in the material world that when a person becomes very opulent, he easily becomes degraded.
这个在物质世界经常发生，当一个人变得非常富有的时候，他就会贪婪堕落。
So this is true for an individual, for one person, and it can also be true for a whole nation of people. Hare Krishna, Subhuti. Sati.Hare Bhau.
Hare Krishna. Good day.
Is Subhuti there?
Yes. Oh, we lost our...
Tabuzai.
Yes.
Yogita Dati Mama.
Good day, 你稍等一下啊，我跟他联络一下，如果他那儿网络不行的话，我问问看看其他班有没有人在。
Hare Krishna.
Oh, 回来了。
不好意思，网络掉了。
好。Sati.
好的，不对。
他回来了。
是的，是的。
OK。我们继续。Anyway, 我们谈when some people get too much money, sometimes it will affect somebody, or it may affect one person, or it may affect a whole country of people.
如果一个人他有很多的钱的时候，他有时候会影响其他的人，不仅如此，他还会影响整个国家。
Just like the demigods, they're supposed to be in the mode of goodness, but sometimes they get very proud, they get too much opulence.
就像半世人，他本来应该处于善良属性之中，但是如果得到了太多的财富，他也会产生骄傲。
Just like Indra, the king of the demigods, sometimes he falls down because of too much opulence.
就像这里的 Indra, 由于太多的物质富裕，他堕落了。
And Prabhupada says, we can see the same thing happening in America.
圣帕帕德在这里提到，这样的事情也正发生在美国。
He said the American people, the American country became very advanced in material opulence, but they didn't produce any good quality people.
圣帕帕德在这里说，虽然美国已经成为非常富裕的国家，但是它并没有产生非常有品质的人。
And now we see in America they have.Problem with so much crime.
而且美国现在有很多的犯罪。
And the people who are running the country in America, they don't know how to solve the problem, how to manage things, and how to get people to follow the laws.
而这些管理美国的这些人，他们也面对这样的问题束手无策。
So people who have no spiritual education, they don't know about the goal of life.
对于那些没有受过灵性教育的人，他们无法知道灵性的目的是什么。
They don't know that we're supposed to go home back to Godhead.
他们不知道人生的目的是为了回归守神，回归家园。
People just try to enjoy material comforts. They just want to satisfy their senses.
人们就是想享受他的生活舒适，想享受这种酒色之中。
And they're very attached. People are very addicted to having alcohol and enjoying the opposite sex.
人们非常沉迷于酒以及异性的这种性生活。
So in such an environment, when people have children.They won't get good quality children. The children will be of very poor qualities.
因此，在这样的一种环境之中，人们无法得到非常有品质的孩子。
So this is what Krishna calls in the Bhagavad Gita, the Varna Sankara, the unwanted population.
这就是主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中所说的不想要的人口 Varna Shankar。
So this creates a hellish, hellish society.
这创造了一个地狱般的社会。
And that's what's going on in America now, just now.
这样的事情正发生在美国。
But America is very lucky because now the Hare Krishna movement has come to America.
但是美国也非常幸运， Hare Krishna 的运动也来到了美国。
And many young men are starting to take seriously the Hare Krishna movement.
许多年轻人正在非常认真地修习 Hare Krishna 运动。
And Hare Krishna movement is meant to produce.The first class men, men of the best character.
Hare Krishna 运动也目的就是想要创造有一流品格的这些人们。
Men who don't eat meat, they don't do illicit sex, they don't do intoxication, and they don't gamble.
这样的人他不吃鱼肉，但不过非法性生活，不吸食麻醉品，不赌博。
So when the American people are serious about trying to stop all the crime in the country, then they have to take to Krishna consciousness.
如果美国人们想抑制这种犯罪的生活，想有一个好的社会的话，他们必须实践 Krishna 知觉的运动。
And they should try to follow the type of system which is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, the Varnashram system.
他必须遵循薄伽梵歌所提倡的 Varna Ashram 这种社会系统。
Right, the society should be divided into four different divisions. First class, second class, third class, and fourth class.
这个社会被分为四个阶层，第一阶层，第二阶层，第三阶层，第四阶层。
But right at this time,The only people they're creating, they're worse, than, they're lower than fourth class.
而现在的这个社会创造的只是比四流阶层的人更低的人。
So of course there will be many criminals. There will be a lot of problems with crime in the country.
所以就这样的情况必然导致这个社会有很多的罪恶犯罪的情况发生。
So the same thing, long, long ago, in the heavenly planets, Indra regretted that he did not respect his spiritual teacher, Brihaspati.
在很久很久以前, Indra 因为对自己灵性导师不尊敬而感到忏悔不已。
So it would be good for the American people to also see their mistake.
同样的道理,这也对美国人如果能够对待自己的错误感到反省的话
yeah, Their mistake was they put too much importance to the advancement of material civilization.
美国人的问题在于他花费了太多的精力在物质文明的进步上。
They should take advice from the spiritual teacher who is the representative of Krishna.
他们应该接受灵性导师的建议，而这些灵性导师代表了主 Krishna。
And if they do that, then they will be happy, and then they'll get an ideal nation to lead the world.
如果他们能够这样做的话，他们会快乐，他们也能够成为一个理想的国家。
Now, somebody may say, well, if somebody is seated on the throne, if they're the king,They shouldn't have to stand up to show respect to another king or a brahmana.
如果有一个人说，一位坐在崇高王座上的人不应该站起来对另外一个国王或者婆罗门致敬的话。
So if somebody says like that, then we can understand they do not understand about religious principles.
如果一个人这样说的话。那么就意味着他完全对宗教原则一无所知。
So it's described that when a king or a president may be sitting on the throne, and somebody may say he does the president or the king, they don't need to show respect to anybody who comes here.
所以呢，维什瓦纳查库瓦就说，当一位总统或国王坐在王座上时，无需向光临殿堂中的每一个人致敬。
But he should show respect to his superiors.
但是他必须应当向那些至尊、向那些高等的人物致敬。
And his superiors mean like his spiritual teachers and the brahmanas and the Vaishnavas.
这些高等的人物，例如他的灵性导师、婆罗门以及 Vaishnava 这样的奉献者。
So in our scriptures, we see many examples about how people are supposed to act to show the right behavior.
在经典中，我们看到了很多人，他们是如何展示恰当的行为的。
Just like when Narada Muni went to visit Lord Krishna in Dwarka.
就像 Narada Muni 和主 Krishna 进入到 Dwarka 的时候。
So Lord Krishna immediately stood up with all of his officers and all the ministers, and everyone offered respects to Narada Muni.
主 Krishna 和其他所有的大臣们还有其他人一起站起来去站起来表示对 Narada Muni 的尊敬之情。
Narada Muni, he knew that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Narada Muni 当然知道主 Krishna 是至尊人格首身。
And Krishna knows that Narada was his devotee.
Krishna 也知道 Narada 是他的奉献者。
But although Krishna is the Supreme Lord and Narada is the devotee of the Lord, still Krishna respected.That followed the etiquette and showed respect to Narada Muni.
尽管主 Krishna 是至尊主 ，Narada Muni 是主的奉献者，但是主仍然遵守了这个礼仪，向 Narada 表示了他的尊敬。
Narada Muni is a brahmachari, and he's also a brahmana, and he's also a very great devotee.
Narada Muni 是一位真守身，他也是位婆罗门。他更是一位非常崇高的奉献者。
So Krishna, when he was a king, he would offer his obeisances to Narada.
所以，尽管 Krishna 是一位国王，他向 Narada Muni 表示了他的尊敬，礼拜了他。
This is the Vedic civilization.
这就是伟大的文化。
And if people don't know how Narada Muni and Krishna should be respected, then that society is not very advanced. If they don't know how to properly respect people like Narada Muni, then it's not a very advanced society.
如果人们并不知道如何尊敬像 Narada Muni 这样的 Krishna 的代表的话，那么这个社会并不是那么的文明和进步。
People should know how to advance in Krishna consciousness.
人们应该知道如何在 Krishna 知觉之中取得进步。
The society, material world, people shouldn't just be concerned only with getting new motor cars and new apartments and bigger houses.
现在的人们，他们只关心如何创造新型的汽车、新型的摩天大楼、新型的这些技术。
And then they break the old ones, and they get the new one, and they break the new one, they get another new one.
他们总是把之前所建设的东西摧毁，然后创造一个新的，然后又把这些东西新的摧毁，然后又去造一个新的。
And so they may be advancing technologically, but they're not human beings. They're not advanced in human culture.
他们或许在技术上取得了一些进步，但是这并不代表的是人类文明。
the civilization societies advance when people follow the Varnashram system.
人类的文明意味着他遵循 Varnashram 这个社会体系。
There has to be first class men, people who are ideal in character.
必须有一些一等阶层的人，他们作为人类的他们有这种非常理想的品格。
And they should be able to act as advisors and tell people what's the right thing to do for the material and spiritual benefit.
他们作为整个社会的他能够给予建议，能够给予人们如何在灵性上以及物质上生活。
And then the second class men are like the Kshatriyas, they should be able to be administrators.
二流阶层的人们，他们应该作为整个社会的管理者。
And the third class men will produce the food, do the farming, protect the cows.
三流阶层的人们，他们应该生产粮食，保护奶牛。
And the fourth class men, they'll do what the other people tell them, what the leaders, what the first class, second class, and third class men tell them to do.
而四流阶层的人们，他们应该做第一阶层、第二阶层以及第三层阶层的人告诉给他所做的一些事情。
And if we don't follow this, then we're all fifth class men.
如果我们不遵循这个社会体系，我们则属于第五等阶层的人。
So if we don't have the Vedic rules and regulations, then it won't be a very good society.
如果没有伟大的规范和原则，不会是一个很好的社会。
People won't know what's the real aim of life. They won't know what's the highest principle of religion.
人们不会知道到底人生的目标是什么，宗教的最高原则又是什么。
All right. So leaders who have fallen into ignorance and mislead people, directing them to the path of destruction. So sometimes we get leaders who are not really good leaders. They're not good leaders.
有些时候我们会有一些很愚昧的领袖。
So they mislead people, and they lead them into all the bad paths, bad habits.
这样的领袖，他带领人们走向一个歧途，走向一条误途。
So these leaders, they're like taking people on a boat, which is made of stone.
他带领人们乘上了一艘石头船。
And the people who follow them, they're also condemned. They're also very stupid for following such leaders.
那些追随这样的领袖的人，他们也非常的愚昧。
If we get on a stone boat, if they tell you this boat, there's a boat, get on the boat, and the boat's made of stone, we should know it's not going to float, it's going to sink.
如果他们都登上了这个石头所造成的船，我们知道石头并不会漂浮在水面上，它在水面上只会沉下去。
So, people, if we mislead people and take them to hell,then the people who follow also, they'll also go with them to hell.
如果那个误导者会去到地狱的话，那么追随这个误导的人，他也会去到地狱。
So conditioned souls, all of us, we are conditioned souls. We have fallen in the ocean of material existence.
我们所有这些受条件限制的灵魂都堕落到这个无知之洋之中。
But the human body is an opportunity to cross over the ocean.
但是人体生命是一个能够跨越这个海洋的机会。
The human body is like a good boat to cross over the ocean.
人体生命 就是一个能够跨越海洋的船。
And the spiritual teacher is just like the captain of the ship.
而灵性导师就是这个船的船长。
And if you have a good captain, then you can easily get across the ocean.
如果你有一个好的船长的话，你可以轻而易举地跨越这个海洋。
And when sometimes you get good winds, a nice wind, and these winds are like the instructions of the Vedic teaching.
有些时候船在海面上行走会遇到一些好的风，这个风就相当于是伟大的训谕。
So if we don't take advantage of all these facilities to get across the ocean, then we're certainly going to commit suicide.
如果人们不利用所有的这些便利条件的话，他肯定是在自杀。
If we get on a boat which is made of stone,There's no way we'll ever get across the ocean.
如果一旦乘上这个石，乘上一个石头做的船的话，这毫无疑问也会毁灭。
So we have to get rid of, we have to give up following all these bogus leaders who present boats of stone. If they only give us a boat of stone, we should know we don't want to follow this person.
我们应该放弃所有这些虚假的领袖。如果他们只是带我们上一艘石头之船的话，我们一定要放弃他们。
So all the human society, all the humans, everybody were in a very dangerous position, and we need to be rescued.
所有的人类社会都处在这种危险的状况之中，他们都应该得到救赎。
We have to follow the instructions of the Vedas.
我们需要遵循伟达经的训谕。
And the cream of the instruction of the Vedas is the Bhagavad Gita.
而伟达经的训示的精华是博迦梵歌。
Bhagavad Gita gives us instructions that we should take shelter. We should get the direct instructions from Krishna on how to achieve the aim of human life.
通过博迦梵歌，我们应该脱避于主 Krishna.
Lord Krishna says, surrender, sarva dharma parikshana, give up all the principles of religion, and just surrender to me.
主 Krishna 说，臣服只是臣服我，放弃所有的宗教只是臣服于我。
So even somebody may not accept Krishna as supreme, we may not agree to accept Krishna as the Supreme Lord, but his instructions are still good, they're still helpful for people.
即便一个人他并不承认主 Krishna 是至尊人格首神，但是主 Krishna 的训谕仍然非常的好。
And if we just follow his instructions, we can be saved.
如果我们能够遵循他的训谕的话，我们也能够得到拯救。
And if we don't follow, then we may be cheated by all of these unauthorized people teaching us gymnastics and hatha yoga and different things. We won't get any benefit.
如果我们不遵循的话，将会受到非权威性的冥想、瑜伽、体操程序这些各种各样的欺骗。
Just like you get on a stone boat, everybody who gets in the stone boat, they're all going to drown.
就像举的这一个上一艘石头做的船的这个例子，所有人在这个石头船上都会淹死。
So Prabhupada says, we see the American people, they're eager to get out of this materialistic mess about.They want to escape all the problems of the material world, but sometimes in their eagerness, they get on a stone boat.
圣帕帕德说，我们看到有一些美国人，他们非常渴望想逃脱这个石头船。
So if you get on a stone boat, it's not going to help them.
他们发现，如果因为他们知道，如果上了一艘石头做的船的话。
The proper boat is the boat offered by Krishna and the Krishna consciousness movement.
一个恰当的船是由 Krishna 知觉和 和主 Krishna 所提供的。
So it is said, if society is just guided by politics, with one nation going against another, then that's just, it's just going to sink like a stone boat.
如果社会只是受到这些政治外交的这些指挥的话，这就是国与国之间产生欺骗，这也会导致产生这种石头船的这种下沉。
Politics won't save the people.
政治诱骗不会拯救人们。
People have to take to Krishna consciousness to understand the ways of life.
人们应该实践 Krishna 之觉，了解生命的目的。
They have to understand the mission of human life.
他们应该知道人生的使命是什么。
Okay, so we will stop there tonight.
Okay. 萨提玛德吉，因为我下线了之后，有几个问题我没有看到，但是前面有三个问题我记下来了，后面的问题我没有看到，就是下线之后这些问题都清空了。您能否再发一下，谢谢。
好的。
OK。第一个问题我这里只有当时只翻译了英文。第一个问题是 ,because, 来自于真真 Mataji, because of the fear of being accused in the past, even facing corrections, I still resist admitting my own problems because of fear.So how to deal with this? 就是他的问题是，因为害怕被指责，所以当即使面临一些正确的指责时，人是不愿意接受自己的问题，如何处理这样的情况？
Well, that fear is due to the bodily concept of life.
你这种害怕是来自于虚体化的概念。
You have to understand you're not the body.There's nothing to be afraid of.
你应该了解我们不是这个躯体，所以没有必要担心什么。
So, we have the shelter of Lord Krishna. There's nothing to fear.
我们托庇于主 Krishna, 没有什么应该感到害怕的。
So you have to do whatever you have to do and depend on Krishna.
你做你应该做的。然后依靠主 Krishna.
Yeah. Next question.
Yeah. Next question is, 是如何避免虚假的谦卑而变得真正的谦卑呢？也是来自于真正 Mataji. How to avoid the false humility and become true humble?
So true humility is to understand I'm a spirit soul, 1/10,000th tip of the hair.
真正的谦卑意味着我们知道自己是一个灵性的灵魂，是发间的万分之一的这个大小。
So you should be willing to offer all respect to others, and you should not expect any respect for yourself.
你应该总是想着向别人致敬，而不求其他任何人给予你的尊敬。
This is qualification. This is genuine humility.
这是真正的谦卑。
Yes.
Next question is: 现实生活中遇到很多的情况，本能的去撒谎，想要变得诚实，对自己诚实，这种勇气从哪里获得呢 ？In reality, I'm automatically to tell lies. I want to be honest, to myself. So how to get this encouragement?
Yes, you have to regret. When you tell lies, you have to regret that you told a lie. You should lament that you told a lie. You should not become habituated to telling lies. It's a very bad habit.
如果你撒谎的话，你应该对自己的这种撒谎感觉到愧疚，感觉到悲伤。这并不是一个很好的习惯，这是一个非常坏的习惯。
When you tell lies, after some time it will be found out that you told a lie, then it's even more worse, it's more embarrassing, very disgraceful.
如果你撒了谎，然后，这是一个which is even more worse. Sorry.
Yeah. Once they discover, when people find out that you told a lie, then it will be more it will be a big disgrace on you.
Okay. 当如果人们发现你撒谎呢，这个对你的这种损失，对你的伤害会更大。
So you should avoid telling lies.
所以你应该避免去撒谎。
You should regret very much.
你应该非常感觉到忏悔。
Of course, sometimes you know you're doing business. Sometimes you're selling things. You have to say for people, you know, for you, I'm making no profit.
当然，如果有些时候你做一些生意，你会说一些丧。或说一些谎话，比如说，哦，我这个事情没有什么利润。
So, people doing business will often talk like that.
人们做生意的时候都会这么去说。
So, you know, you're also in your work sometimes, you know, you're selling houses or apartments, you may have to say, yeah, for you we're making no profit, this is the best price, this is a very fair price.
如果你是卖房子或者说销售这个房子，或者说你可以跟别人说，哦，对了，为你这个我是一点利润都没有，这个给你的是最好的价格。
That's expected from people. That's your job.
这也是人们对你的这个期望，这也是你的职业，你的工作。
But in Krishna consciousness, we should not tell lies.
但是在 Krishna 知觉上，我们不应该说谎。
Just like teacher said, are you chanting 16 rounds? We should tell the truth.
就像老师会问你，你是否念诵了16圈呢？你应该告诉他实话。
Teacher asks you, are you following four principles? We should tell the truth.
你是否遵循了四项基本原则呢？你也应该告诉他实话。
We should not lie to the spiritual teacher.
我们不应该向灵性导师撒谎。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from 毛毛。敬爱的 Gurudev， 请问 Daksha 的使命是生物体的祖先，为什么 Narada Muni 还要试图向他传教呢？Obeisance to Gurudev. I want to know, because of Daksha is Prajapati, why Narada Muni want to preach to him?
Because Narada Muni wants to take people back home, back to Godhead.
因为 Narada Muni 就是想带人们回归守神，回归家园。
We can always get someone else to be a Prajapati.
我们总是能得到一些人，总是会有一些人想要去成为 Prajapati 生物体的祖先。
But it's very important if somebody is interested to try to encourage people. It's good to help them to go back to Godhead.
但是重要的是，有一些人他能够，帮助人们回归守神，回归家园。
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from 真真。内心软弱，总觉得自己总是什么也做不好，总是闭上眼睛想逃避，不敢睁开眼睛面对现实，怎么办？My heart is weakness, and I feel I cannot do anything.And when I close my eyes, I want to escape. I'm not able to open my eyes and face the reality. How to do?
Well, you've got to You got to learn to live with the world, whether you like it or not.
你得学会和这个世界相处，无论你喜欢或者不喜欢这个世界。
Srila Prabhupada explains, he said, we have to make the best of a bad bargain.
圣帕帕德说，我们得学习如何，we have learned the...
To make the best of a bad bargain.
我们得充分利用一个不好的情况。
Just like sometimes you go shopping and you see something and you think, oh, that looks, you know, that's good and it's very cheap. And you think, I think I'll buy it. And you buy it and then you take it home and you find out that it's a copy, it's not the real thing, and it doesn't work very well.
就像你去超市，你发现了一个物超所值的东西，它东西又好，然后价格也还可以，然后你买回去发现这个东西其实只是一个复制品，并没有太好。
是假的东西啊？
是一个假的东西，复制品。
Okay, so what to do with it? You already bought it. You spent the money.You can't take it back. The shop won't take it back and won't give you a refund. So you have to use it.
那这个时候怎么办呢？你买了一个假的东西回去，然后你又超市又不给退，你怎么办？面对这样情况，你得充分的利用它。
So you use it and you get whatever value you can from it.
那你就好好的利用你手上现有的这个东西，无论它能够为你创造什么价值，你就把它用好就行。
So material body is like that.
所以这个物质躯体也是这样一个情况。
It's not a very good thing.
物质躯体并不是一个很好的事情。
We know we have many faults, many things not good.
我们知道我们现在有很多的错误，有很多不好的东西。
But we have to use it.
但我们还是得用它。
Try to use it. Somehow may help us to get out of the material world.
好好的去用它，然后利用着它，离开这个物质世界。
We only have this one body, you don't have another body, so you have to use that body you've got.
你只有这个躯体，你没有其他的躯体，所以你就利用好你得到的现有的这个躯体。
You may not like it, you know, there's so many things wrong with it, so many things not very good about it.
你或许并不喜欢它，然后也有很多的毛病，但是你就只有这个。
So you have to use it and do what you can. Try to serve Krishna.
所以你得好好的用它，尽可能的做一些事情去服务 Krishna。
Try to use it to get out of the material world.
利用好它，去努力尝试着离开这个物质世界。Next question from Mathur Nina Madhaji. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和所有的奉献者，请问 Guru, Goloka 是没有二元性，还是那里的灵魂超越了二元性？ Question from 张云昌。Hare Krishna, the obeisances to Guru, and I want to ask, in the Goloka Vrindavan, is there none of 二元性
Duality.
Yeah, duality. Or the soul in Goloka, they transcend the duality.
Then, yeah, in Goloka, there's no duality.
在 Goloka 是没有二元性的。
Goloka, there's only transcendental bliss.
在 Goloka 只有超然的极乐。
Different varieties of transcendental bliss.
有多种多样性，还有超然的极乐。
sometimes with Krishna and sometimes separated from Krishna.
有些时候和 Krishna 在一起，有些时候和 Krishna 分离。Next question from Jai Govinda Mataji. 顶拜 Guru 和翻译，有许多年都没有见过面的奉献者朋友、瑜伽非奉献者朋友、瑜伽同行，突然邀请我去参加他的婚礼。在中国我有随份子的习俗，我担心这样做有业报，我内心很抵触，但物质的人际关系也需要维护。请问 Guru， 我该如何恰当面对这样的事情，来保护我的灵性知觉？谢谢。Hare Krishna, obeisance Gurudev. There are some yoga teacher is my friend, but non-devotees. They ask me to join her wedding. In China, we have culture. In the wedding, we need to give some money. This is our culture. So I'm afraid if I give some money, it will have some karma inside. In my heart, I'm not want to join, but I also want to maintain this relationship. I want to ask a guru, how can I face this problem and protect my spiritual consciousness? Thank you.
So you want to protect your spiritual consciousness? That's certainly very important. You have to be very careful what kind of things you take part in.
你要保护你的灵性的知觉，这当然是非常重要的。那你就得思考你要参加什么。
I don't really know very much about the relationship there. It depends a lot how closely connected you are with this friend. Certainly, you have to give. You want to give some present. You can give something, but you don't have to give. You don't have to give a lot. That's the point.
通常情况下，你可以给一些礼物，但你也不用给太多。
Because people at this time, of course, people don't have money.
当然，现在的这个情况下，人们并没有太多的钱。
The whole economy all over the world is affected. People don't have much money. So somebody's getting married, they won't expect you to give much money.
整个国际的这个经济都受到影响，人们并没有太多的钱。他邀请你参加他的婚礼，也可能并没有想要你很多钱。
As for going to the wedding, I don't think you want to go. I don't think you need to go. You just make an excuse, say you have a class.
关于去参加这个婚礼，我觉得你没有必要去参加这个婚礼。你可以找一个借口说你有课。
Certainly, it's not for your spiritual benefit to go there.
很确定的就是说，你如果去参加那个，对你的灵性并没有什么帮助。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Subita Sangha Mataji. Hare Krishna, 感恩顶拜 Guru 的莲花组顶拜翻译和老师和奉献者们，请问姑人，您生活中灵修之人经常说善意的谎言，这会对灵修有损伤吗？ Hare Krishna, basis to Guru, I want to ask, we usually hear about the practice, the spiritual practice, the people who practice, the spiritual path, they often say thatpeople can say some the kindly lies. So if these kindly lies have some damage to the spiritual practice?
Kindly life.
Kindly life means is life, but is not harm.
What do they do?
This kind of life can harm to the spiritual practice.
What kind of life is it? What do they do?
善意的谎言.
More the goodness.
Yeah.
What are the farmers?
I don't know.
I have to know more about what the people do to know if it's harmful.
Oh, 就是说，姑想知道这个善意的谎言具体是怎样的，它到底有没有伤害？
他们做什么活动？他们吃什么东西？他们的身份怎么样？Are these people everywhere, all over China, or all over the world, or where?
Gurudev, I think she wants to ask, this kind of life can, there is a kind of life, but not harm to the others, but is life.
Life.
So she wants to ask her, lie, tell lie.
Lie.
Yeah, lie.
说谎.
Yeah, 说谎.
Oh. And she wants to ask what?
This 善意的谎言，这个善意的说谎，是否对灵修 this goodness of lie can...harm to the spiritual practice?
Well, it depends what you're telling lies about. It depends who you're telling lies to. Generally, we try to be truthful.
通常情况下我们是要说真话，所以这个要考虑到你善意的谎言是对谁说，以及这个善意的谎言说的内容是什么。
Now, of course, sometimes we do have to tell lies. Sometimes,it's necessary, just like sometimes people ask us, you know, do you have a belief, do you have a religion? You just say, no, I don't believe anything.
有些时候我们也不得不说谎，比如说有人问你，你有什么信仰吗？你到底信仰什么？你有什么宗教心吗？然后你有宗教信仰吗？你可能就会回答，我没有什么信仰。
We don't want to say anything which is going to get us in trouble.
我们不会说一些事情让我们导致我们会产生麻烦的事情。
We just want to try to, you know, avoid trouble. We want to keep out of trouble.
我们说这样的谎话只是为了避免一些麻烦，不会避免一些麻烦。
So everything depends on the time and the place and the circumstances.
所以一切都取决于时间以及特定的时间地点以及特定的情况。
Just like Lord Krishna told lies to kill Drona.
就像主 Krishna 也说了一个谎去杀多纳。
When Mother Yashoda was asking Krishna, have you been eating dirt? Krishna said, no. I said, these boys are lying, telling lies about me.
当亚修达妈妈问主 Krishna, 你到底吃了这个泥土吗？主 Krishna 说，哦，这些小孩撒谎了，他并没有吃。
Yeah, they're jealous of me, so they're telling lies about me.
他们指责我，所以他们说谎了。
So sometimes, you know, that for pastimes, Krishna will also tell lies.
所以为了一些逍遥时光，主 Krishna 也说了谎。
So everything depends the time and the place and the circumstances.
一切都取决于时间、地点以及特定的情况。
So you have to be intelligent to judge where it's necessary and where it's not.
你得有智慧去评判，去分辨到底哪些地方是可以的，哪些地方是不可以的。
Okay, yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Hare, next question from Sati Mataji. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada.If a devotee cannot develop love for Krishna, what is the reason for this? Does that mean that there is something wrong with sadhana? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，一切荣耀归圣帕帕。如果一个奉献者不能发展出对 Krishna 的爱，那是什么原因造成的这样的情况呢？是不是意味着他的规范修习有一些问题？
Yes, it could be.It could be because it's Guifan Shosen Buhao. It could also be that he's too much attached to the material world. He doesn't want to let go.
这个有，这个有可能是sadhana 不好，也有可能是他对物质的依附太多，而并不想放弃这种物质的依附。
Material attachment is a big obstacle.If we're very attached to the material world, then it's very hard to develop love for Krishna.
如果我们非常依附于这个物质的世界的话，我们很难发展出对 Krishna 爱。
So we have to let go of the material world.
我们得放弃这个物质世界的依附。
Okay.
Okay, this question from Yuna Mataji. Next question from Hani Vamsa, 顶拜 Guru. 我结婚时给了我陕西宝鸡奉献者妻子的父母10万礼金。我在南昌办素食婚礼还还了一二万。素食婚礼还花了一二万，然后岳父岳母用已经办婚宴了，请问这个对我们夫妻的灵性成长，有影响吗？ Obeisances to Guru. When I get married, I give my mother, father-in-law 100,000 RMB, and I use 10,000 to hold a vegetarian feast. So, but my mother, father-in-law, they use this 100,000 money, RMB, to hold a meat feast. So it will have some harmful to me and my wife.
Yes.
On the spirit, 是会有影响的。
Yes, you get karma.
你会有业报。
What to do? You can't avoid this kind of karma sometimes.
你能怎么做呢？有些时候你也不能避免这样的情况的发生。
Anyway, now you're married, now it's finished. You don't give them any more money.
不管怎样，你现在的婚礼已经结束了，你再不用给钱了。And he asked, then he asked, in Chinese culture, how the devotees should do? and care about. When we facing some reality, relatives and some kind of wedding and some feast, we should give some money.
Well, if everybody's giving money and you've gone to the wedding, then you also have to give something.
如果别人给你红包的话，你也应该给予别人一点东西。
Right? You don't have to give a lot, but you maybe have to. You have some social obligation. You have some obligation. You went to the wedding, so you have an obligation to give something.
比如说你参加婚礼，你有这个礼节，需要给予一些东西。
But you don't give them too much.
你不用给予别人特别多。
Because you know, you know that they're not devotees. They're not going to use the money for Krishna.
因为你知道他们不是奉献者，他们不会用这个钱去服务 Krishna。How should we face about this like that? If we accept others' money, relatives' money, what should we do?
You should use it for Krishna.
如果你接受一些亲戚的红包的钱的话，你应该用这个钱去服务 Krishna.
Yeah, you use it to worship Krishna. You make nice prasadam, and you can distribute prasadam.
你可以用这个钱去服务 Krishna, 崇拜 Krishna, 去做一个 prasada, 然后用这个 prasada 派发出去。
You can invite all the your friends, all the people you know to come and have nice prasadam together.
你可以做一个大餐，然后邀请你所有的朋友来荣耀这个 prasada.
And together you can all chant Hare Krishna mantra.
在一起，你们还可以一起，所有人都唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
That's very nice. You do that.
如果你这样做的话，会非常好。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Wen Yan. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和所有的奉献者，请问 Guru, 我在2018年11月25号在成都托庇于您，您接受了我的托庇，但由于新冠疫情，您来不了中国，不能与您亲身联谊。您现在能启迪我吗？我还可以以怎样的方式与您联谊？您可以给我您的联系方式吗 ？Hare Krishna. This mother asked, he get shelter of you in the 2018, and she wants to get.
在什么地方？
成都。
哦，成都。
文燕。文燕妈的姐。
文燕。Okay, so she should get in touch with Chandra Vilasini. Chandra Vilasini is there.
Chandra Vilas Mataji, 您在这儿吗？您可以和这个 Chandra Vilas Mataji 联系。
Nirenshitama?
Mataji, Guru 问你，你认识他吗？这个文燕 Mataji.
Who is she associating with in Chengdu?
Chandra Vinasi Mataji 在这里说，他古鲁他说他认识这个new devotees.
Does she come for the program? Does she associate with them?
他说这文燕 Mataji， 你参加了 Chandra Vinasi Mataji 的联谊吗？Chandra Vinasini Mataji 说他认识这个 Mataji， 但是还没有和他联谊过，没有参加。
So if she wants to get initiation, she has to go regularly for association.
如果你想得到启迪的话，你应该有规律的参加联谊。
Yeah, there are devotees there in Chengdu. She should associate with them.
在成都有奉献者，你应该和奉献者经常联谊。
There's several devotees there in Chengdu.
在成都有很
Roma Padaswami has disciples there. Girihari Swami has disciples there. You can associate with any of them.
Romapa Swami 有门徒，然后 Girihari Swami 也有门徒，你可以和他们任何一个组联谊。
But you need to associate.
She said she associate in Shenzhen.
Huh? She associate in Shenzhen. Who with?
你在深圳和谁联谊了？ She said she often associate in Shenzhen.
But she's living in Chengdu.
她说她现在在深圳，现在在深圳经常参加联谊。She's now in Shenzhen.
Okay, so who is she associating with?
请问您在深圳和谁联谊？
What is she doing in Shenzhen?
Shama Lata 说，亲爱的 Gurudev， 这个 Mataji 文彦 Mataji 在深圳和 Sridhar Prabhu 这里和我们一起联谊，和 Sridhar Prabhu 联谊。
Okay. So then they have to recommend. Sridhar will recommend.
这样的话，你就如果你经常参加他们联谊的话，你应该邀请 Sridhar Prabhu 推荐你才行。
Wait for a little while. Sridhar will come back to Shenzhen, and then you have to talk to him about it.
你要等一等，然后需要经过 Sridhar Prabhu 的推荐，请 Sridhar Prabhu 推荐你。
But I cannot just give initiation on my own.
我不能独自给予启迪。
You have to get recommendation.
你需要得到其他，需要得到奉献者的推荐。
Okay.
Okay. Question finished.
No more questions?
Yes, yes. No more question.
Okay. So, Vamaganshiya Subhuti Rai Prabhu gave Vamajantai Dufani, Vamaganshiya Sarada functions of LinkedIn, Vamaganshiya Satimati Jujur,Ayoshi, Ganshi, sorry to function, Zegi, Woman Fu, Banju, Woman Jufu, Niman, Shangha, Kwaila, Wanshi, Rui, Chuanjo, Shunli, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada, Ki.
Jai, Hare Krishna, thank you, Guru.